Ooh. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing really well. So today's video, I have got the Aladdin collection from Makeup Revolution. I went for Princess Jasmine. There's so many different other collections. There's like Princess and the Frog, Little Mermaid. I love the Little Mermaid, but I'm a bit obsessed with Princess Jasmine at the minute. We watched the new Disney film as a family around Christmas time and I just absolutely fell in love with Princess Jasmine. Strong princess, and I love that about her. Yeah, let's dive in to check out the collection. First of all, these collections are so cute. Like literally, they're little Disney books, which is just absolutely amazing. Of course, they are Disney stories, and the fact that the palettes come in books, I just absolutely love that about them. So lots of different ones you can choose from. Aladdin is the most recent one. So let's have a look inside the palette and see what look we're gonna go for today. The colors in this are so stunning. Like, I can see all the colours from the story in there, but I also see, like, Lee Dry Nose colours in there as well. Very reflective with the plastic covers on. Ooh. Ooh. Satisfying. You know when something's just satisfying? Love that. So, oh, yeah, they look so much brighter. Bolder underneath there. So, I'll peel the other one off. Do a close-up so you can get the satisfaction. I ain't got no. Right. Love that. These are so pretty as well. So I do believe that these are blushes and then these are highlighters. That colour is absolutely stunning. All the colours in here are so bold and bright. Like, I could really do a gorgeous, bright, bold look. Definitely want to go see Lee's Rhinos again. I'll be using these colours here. They're so, so pretty. So, obviously, we've got in there Princess Jasmine colour. The blue up here is the genie colour. Magic lamp, Abu. Three wishes, Raja. I love that Raja colour. And Marketplace as well. So, I think I might go for an autumnal look today because there's some absolutely beautiful autumnal colours in this palette. And of course, seeing as I didn't get to make a video on this in August, I will make on October. Gosh, we're gonna be at Halloween-y soon, aren't we? I'll make a really nice kind of October fall autumnal eye look. I'll leave everything I use today makeup wise in the description box because sometimes it's the same old, like primers and foundations and such. So I'll leave everything I use down in the description box. Then I'm just going to be using another eyeshadow palette for a mirror today, so don't get confused with holding a different eyeshadow palette. So who is your favourite Disney princess? I absolutely love Moana. In fact, I think Moana is my favourite, like, ever Disney movie. I just love it so much. Like, the music from that film is, like, absolutely stunning. I could just listen to the soundtrack, and I'm not really a soundtracky person. Like, I absolutely love music, and you know, I love songs that are in Disney films when I'm watching the films, but I'm not essentially somebody who would listen to soundtracks. But I absolutely love the Moana soundtrack, and I know lots of friends and family members as well that say the same. They can just, like, listen to the Moana soundtrack on replay. So yeah, Moana's definitely my favourite, but I do absolutely love Princess Jasmine as well. I just really love a strong Disney princess. Gone are the days of these princesses that waited around for a prince to save them. Like, literally, girl, save your own life because you alone are the main character in your own life. So being that main character, go out there, live the life you want to live. Don't sit around waiting for a prince to make you happy, girl. Make yourself happy. And that goes for the boys out there as well. Like, literally, don't sit on your ass waiting for a princess neither. Yeah, so I absolutely love the stronger princesses. I'm obsessed with sponges now. So this is from the Harley Quinn sponge. Sorry, I was just remembering recently watched the wall. Oh my god. The Wolf of Wall Street, and yeah, I saw Margot in a different light, let's just say. But yeah, she's a helpful lady. I'm loving the Beauty Bay brow collection that I've been using as well. I tried this out in my was it the last video I did? Possibly. And yeah, I used it the other night when I went out and I absolutely loved it. So these spoolies come in a pack of about 6 spoolies. I'm just going to use this until the point where I can't use it anymore and then get a new one, because I just wash it after every use. So it is a brow soap anyway. So I just kind of clean it with the brow soap itself and then like give it a nice good rinse. Absolutely loving this. It's just a simpler way to do brows, and I am growing my brows out. So, you know, if you think my brows are messy, that's why. I feel like if you're not the best at doing brows, which I often am not, then I just feel like this is a really simplistic way of doing your brows. I mean, obviously, if you like to make your brows a bit dark or whatever, then you can add a pencil in there as well. But I just think maybe if you're in a rush or anything and you just really want to brush your brows, make them look a bit thicker and a bit more put together, I think this is like the quickest and easy way to do it. This is what I've done with the Joker tin. I've literally put a lot of my makeup brushes in it. I'll link any brushes that I do use today down in the description. I'll probably mainly go for the Joker brushes from the Revolution Joker collection, because I just really like them. They're fun and they're really good brushes as well. So my goodness, I think I'm gonna go in with Marketplace first. It's a really good color collection for bright deep colors, but it's got some lovely nudes in as well. So yeah, I think it's an absolutely stunning palette, and for any Disney fan, so refreshing to have a palette that's not like, you know, getting eyeshadows floating everywhere. Like last week was just ridiculous. I had to back the floor after last week's Primark video. My goodness. Oh, I haven't primed my eyes. Oh my goodness. I mean, it's really nice and colourful without primer as it is, but I'm going to go in and prime my eyes. Primer Potion from Urban Decay. I totally balls that up and got primer on my eyelashes. So we'll start again with Marketplace. Ooh. Yeah, you can see what a difference primer actually does make. Like, the colour was still strong and beautiful on the eye, but with the primer, it makes it so much more bolder. And I feel like it makes the colour more true as well. It really makes it pop. That is really pretty. I'm going to go in with Raja next. That is so lovely. Now I'm just going to blend that out with a clean brush. I'm going to go in with a little bit of Boo next, this colour here. Oh my goodness, that is beautiful. That is beautiful. I always feel like when Makeup Revolution puts their palettes together, that they are always colours that will naturally go well with each other. Of course, they're colours from their interpretation of the colours from the movie, but they generally will all go well together. So I'm just going to go in with a bit of a flatter brush to really pack down that pigment. The colours feel really creamy when I'm picking them up on the brush, and I think I'm just feeling it extra more this week because the eyeshadows that I was using last week from Primark were, spoiler alert if you haven't watched that video, the pigments were really like dry, powdery and dusty. So these just feel so like silky and like the substance when I'm applying the brush to them. Really nice using a decent palette after after not using a decent palette in my last video. I'm going with Soul, really rich and dark, kind of brownish, plumish colour. So I'm just laying the colours down for the time being, and then I can always do some blending a bit later on. Just kind of getting the colours down where I want them as we go along. I think this is my favourite colour so far. Time to Fly. Beautiful. I think I could have actually used a brush for this. In fact, I'll swatch that on the hand. stunning. And I'm going to just use this brush for it, just clean it off a bit on my pages. Yeah, it's a nice creamy colour that you can definitely use your brush for. Oh, that is stunning. These formulas, I mean, I'm always impressed with Makeup Revolution. Some palettes more than others. This is definitely an impressive palette. A bit like the DC one as well that I'm using as a mirror. Really impressive formulas. I love that the story of Aladdin kind of teaches that all we ever need to be is our true selves. Like when, I don't know, when you're dating or whatever, you can always try and impress somebody. But really, what people fall for is just the true you. So Aladdin's like trying to show Princess Jasmine. He's trying to be a prince. He's trying to fake being a prince and he wants to show her the world, to impress her. But actually, she's just interested in the world that's within him. That I absolutely think it's a really beautiful story. I absolutely love it. I love how strong Princess Jasmine is as well. Like she knows what she wants and she just like goes out and gets it, and she protects the family, which is really lovely. I've got a really nice relationship with my dad. I'm very protective of my dad as well. It's just a really nice story. What is your favourite Disney story? Do really love this one. I really love Moana. I think that's my favourite. What else do I like? Rapunzel. Maximus is just amazing in that film, isn't he? And Pascal. Disney animals are always cool, aren't they? I've just put clean pyjama bottoms on and I've made them all messy with my cleaning my brush off. I want to go in with Jafar and really deepen this look up in the corner. We just watched Nightmare Before Christmas last Sunday, family favourite. I was quite old when I first saw The Nightmare Before Christmas. Like, I'd seen Jack the Pumpkin King on books and things, and I thought he looked really cool. Totally my vibe and aesthetic. And then I watched the film for the first time, I do believe, it was when I was pregnant with Freya. Yeah, I was definitely in my 20s when I watched it for the first time, and it was one of Freya's favorite, it still is like Freya's favorite film, but she absolutely loved it when she was very little. Like, I feel like a lot of kids might be scared of it when they're really young. I'm talking about a toddler. But she absolutely loved it and still does. I forgot to say as well, these are all cruelty free and vegan. I keep singing Taylor Swift songs and I'm gonna have to cut it out because I don't want, like, you know, any copyright issues. But she's another really strong woman, isn't she? Like, she's absolutely amazing. She stands up for herself. Like, she has had some shit in the music industry. If you haven't watched a documentary, you don't have to like Taylor Swift to watch a documentary, but it's just absolutely brilliant. I watched it a year or two ago and I couldn't believe, I was unaware that she got some like stick from Kanye West on stage when she just accepted award. Like, the young girl should have been celebrating, not getting some shit from another artist. I mean, he's a grown man. It's really uncalled for. But yeah, she's another powerful, strong woman that, I don't know, she doesn't let anyone bring her down, does she? She'll just stand her ground and write a song about it. Yeah, I just absolutely love how strong she is, and her music as well. I just love her music. I've always loved country music because, like, I grew up listening to the Eagles. So when I get my guitar out, I'm always playing like Eagles tunes as well as like other music that I absolutely love. Big into Taylor at the minute, so I'm just trying to play some Taylor Swift songs on my guitar. When I'm editing, half of what's going on is, I mean, I'm singing, I'm dropping bits absolutely everywhere, like dropping brushes all over the place, palettes everywhere. Yeah, I'm glad I edit my own videos. The colour Abu, where it hits that time to fly over the top there slightly, looks absolutely stunning. I absolutely love the look how it is, and normally I would mirror as above so below, but I mean, seeing as Princess Jasmine is my queen, I'm gonna have to use Princess Jasmine under the eye a little bit. But the colours, I mean, you can see already, they're gonna go really well together. Yes! Oh my God, I love it! Oh, it's such a pretty blue. Kind of really snatches the eye. I like it. Do feel like I want to highlight the brow bone slightly, so I'm going to go in with Light My Lamp. I'm going to bronze a Cave of Wonders just to see what it is like as a bronze. It actually works quite well. It's a nice subtle bronze. Probably a bit more of a blushy colour, but I just thought it's not working as a bronzer, is it? Diamond in the Rough as a blush, because this looks absolutely stunning. Got to bear in mind that the angled blusher brush from the Body Shop does pick up a lot of pigment. Give it an extra few taps off. But that is absolutely stunning colour. So let's add a tiny little bit of Official Wish over the top of that, because we have got a really nice mix of oranges and pinks on the face already. That is stunning. Just gonna blend it a little bit with a clean brush. I feel like this brush from Makeup Revolution from the Joker palette picks up real delicate amount of product, whereas the angled blusher brush from the Body Shop kind of picks up too much if you're not careful. Bit of a balance between the two works well. And I think the more and more I do these videos, the more and more I am more open to wearing a bit of a stronger blush than normal. So of course I will go in with Light My Lamp for highlights. Oh, it's so pretty. Looks really, really light in the pan. I do feel like it'll suit a lot of skin tones. Comes out a little bit more goldy than white, I do think. What am I going to do when I have really wrinkly crow's feet? Because I'm so obsessed with highlighter. I'll just have to use it a bit lighter, or do you know what, fuck it, I'm just gonna have glittery face and I just don't give a shit. That'll be me. I will be this amazing older lady, isn't there? And she like wears like whatever she wants, and she like, she, I'm sure she does like makeup videos, or I've seen them, I'm sure I've seen on Facebook this lady that's just a total glamour puss. She's like literally, give me the highlight, give me the glitz, give me the glam, give me the bold, wacky colours, and I'm just going to live my best life. Like, literally, guys, we should all just live our best life. Whatever makes us happy, do it. Like, literally. You know, if you've got loads of lines on your face, you still want to put loads of highlighter on, go for it. Work that highlighter. Love it. Just love highlighter. I feel like everyone has their kind of favorite makeup product. Mine's definitely highlighter, because you can brush your brows. My cheeks are always quite red anyway, but, and the Fresh New Foundation Away, I guess, always gives a bit of a gleam anyway, but for me, I think my favorite part of makeup is definitely highlighter. I don't know, it makes me so happy when I apply it, because it's like the finishing touches to the skin. I just absolutely adore it. So today I think I will go on with a bit of Urban Decay setting spray. I really like this look, so let's just make it last for the rest of the day, because I'm absolutely living for this look. Sometimes I do makeup looks and I'm like, oh my goodness, that is far too bold for the school run, but flipping love this. And you know, this Halloween I might even do the school run with Halloween makeup on. We just need to see how scary it is. Oh, I just realized as well, I did get another highlighter, because you know, I'm like, I am obsessed with highlighter and I forgot to use it. So this is, I might have to break the box on this one because I can't get in it. So I did get a highlighter all on its own, and again, see, that's really pretty. Ooh, that is gorgeous. So that has got genie lamp in it. Oh, that is so pretty. Do you know what, I'll highlight the inner corner with this because it's just stunning. Highlight the inner corner. I'm actually using a lip and concealer brush from the Body Shop, because it's just literally a small enough brush to get on the inner corner there. Oh yeah, that is really pretty. So let's swatch this highlighter. Put it with the other ones. Oh my goodness, that is absolutely gorgeous. Oh my goodness, I think that might be my favorite one. Absolutely stunning. Lip gloss topper that comes with this collection. All these items are available to buy individually. That is the Aladdin lip topper, which looks absolutely stunning. So we have to involve this. I just want to bob it on quickly to see what it's like on its own. Oh. Wow. So it's really pretty on its own. The lip colour, the natural colour of my lips. Like I can't really see a blue. They just look really kind of purpley reddish. I do really think that's a pretty colour on its own. Because it's a topper, I will go ahead and try it over. This is the lightest colour of the two that Soph does in her collection. Don't know its name, so I'll leave it linked down below. So let's try it over the top of this. So let's make it extra magical with the sparkly Aladdin lip topper. Oh. It just adds a really nice subtle shimmer over the top. I think that's really pretty. I think that lip topper will look nice over lots of different shades of lipstick because it looked nice enough over the natural lip itself. It wasn't like too blue and sparkly, it just enhanced the colour of the lips. So yeah, I really like this look, my goodness. Like I said earlier, I'm absolutely living for this look. I just think it's absolutely stunning. I'm so pleased that I did go for that gorgeous Princess Jasmine blue underneath the autumnal eye colours. I just think it works really well. It kind of lightens up the eye a little bit, I think. If you wanted a heavier look, then of course you could mirror the above and maybe put on some eyeliner as well. But I really like how that blue really just kind of lighten up the eye area. It's really different look for me and I'm absolutely loving it. So this palette and everything else that I've tried today from the Aladdin collection is just a winner from me. It's definitely up there with my top palettes. It might even be my favourite. Do really, really like it. Like I'm really happy with the blush colours, really happy with the highlighter colours in there, and just the colour palette itself of eyeshadows. I mean, that blue up there looks stunning, doesn't it? But there's such gorgeous autumnal colours in if you're looking for an autumnal palette. It's got bright colours in there, it's got really deep colours in, and of course it also has some neutral colours. So I think it's a really good palette for any Disney fan, any Aladdin fan. I absolutely love it. I think it's so cute. I love how you could actually put it on your shelves and it would look like a little book as well. I just think they've really well planned out this collection and all their little Disney collections, because we just pop all the palettes side by side in a bookshelf and I just think it'd look absolutely stunning. Especially for me, I'm like running out space of storing palettes. Now I could start off a little collection on a bookshelf or something and it just looked really beautiful. It's definitely a winner from me. I'm obsessed with it. And now I've tried this one, I'm gonna have to go ahead and like collect them all. I'm really happy with this look. Let me know down below if you have got a favourite Disney palette from Makeup Revolution, what your favourite Disney character is. Is there a Disney character that you would love to see them do a palette with? This is not a sponsored video. This is just me wanting to know because I just think they're so fun. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave it a thumbs up and subscribe if you are new. It's free to do so. Live your best life. Be the main character in your life. Have a fantastic week and I'll see you all next Tuesday. Thanks guys. Bye. So I'm really feeling feeling time to fly. All day am I feeling that. You go. That is gorgeous. That has got the little, I was like, take off.